your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson. To settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one, and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is that I had two, and I'm trying to end one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Oui.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks, trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Nah. I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on the boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true. Especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute and he was her, well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read. Taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man, in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left. Or tried to leave. Said too much, Bonnie. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston.
Pussy.
Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
Y aquí se explica por qué cuando no jugamos el juego por primera vez. Ya sabía hacer cosillas. Que todo el mundo nos quedábamos en plan, tío. ¿Por qué sabe hacer todo?
They're lucky to have a man like you.
I ain't so sure about that, but thank you.
Good to see you, Miss McFarlane.
Whoa! Whoa there!
That's it! Keep on moving!
He's got it!
Hey!
Nice job, Mr. Marston!
Whoa.
Herd the cows down the road. Pretend you know what you're doing.
Ain't that hard, is it?
Get at y'all.
Venga, vamos. Wow, me acuerdo de pequeño, esta misión era un coñazo, tío. Porque las vacas eran suicidas. Solo misiones. Se puede ir por aquí. Tengo marcado lo que yo creo, ¿no? Ah, no, calla, vale. Vale. Está en otro sitio, me he equivocado yo. Se puede ir también. Pero esto no es Red Dead Redemption 2. Aquí realmente se llaman los caminos cortos. Vale. Sorry. Ese era un caníbal. Y el de los no muertos te lo encuentras también con una pareja zombie.
Excuse me, sir. You need help? Mister, you alive?
Fuck. God damn it. Good heavens.
Excuse me?
I said, no, I'm not okay. Do I look like I'm okay?
You look pretty good for a corpse.
Praise be.
Move up, mister. Time to get you to a doctor or an undertaker. Whichever you need once we get to town.
St. Peter, open up them pearly gates. I'm coming home.
Come on, mister. Come on.
Hurry, sir. I'm bleeding like a badly butchered hog.
You'll be fine. Just focus.
You better take the reins. I don't think I'm strong enough.
I'm finished. Done for.
Just sit up straight, will you?
The closest doctor is in Armadillo.
El puto Dickens, tío.
What is your name, friend?
John Marston.
Good God! Out of the frying pan into the fire! Excuse me.
How many outlaws can a man encounter?
Dios, es verdad.
You must have me mistaken with somebody else, friend.
Good Lord! It's those scoundrels once again!
Es más, este sí que nos conoce de la vida anterior.
Excellent work, sir. Push on to Armadillo.
What the hell happened to you?
Bandits, hoodlums. Scoundrels robbed me blind and left me to die.
I can see that.
Once again, a victim of my own success.
Juju.
They seem a man in a well-cut suit and this happens.
Do you know who they were?
No idea. I'm not the kind of man who has enemies.
No.
You do now.
I give so much and still they take. We live in an uncivilized and graceless world, friend.
¿Sí, verdad?
Our maker has a funny sense of humor sometimes. Still, at least I met you. Good Samaritan in wolf's clothes. I want to put that gun away just yet.
Bueno, te voy a engañar que si te muriese tampoco te echaría mucho de menos.
Why you want a gun?
Why you running? Venga.
What? I knew this wasn't my time. He has a greater purpose for me.
You're delirious and playing dumb, friend.
Is that Armadillo? Come on, hurry!
Man, you're gonna be fine.
Take
We're nearly there.
Into your arms.
You need more than a doctor, my friend. This is it. You're gonna make it.
Oh, where the devil are we?
Armadillo. We made it safe. You'll be happy to know.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. You're a gentleman and a true man of honor.
Coming from you, I doubt that means much, but I appreciate the civility.
I owe you, sir. And I always pay my debts. Jesus! But if I die, I'm sorry for it. If not, I'll be your man for...
Let's get you fixed up first. Then we'll decide what you're my man for.
Este tío me hace una gracia, el Dickens. De pequeño me caía muy mal. Pero muy, muy mal, de hecho. ¿Cuánto costaba la casa de aquí, por cierto?
Suppose not all men are bad. I won't forget what you did here.
Glad to be of service to the oldest profession. Sorry, miss. My fault. Why don't you jump up?
Voy a hacer esta misión antes, ya que estoy aquí ya.
Ah, since you're here, you want to make yourself useful?
Not particularly.
Listen, son, I know you got a mission. Right now, I need another gun.
Why? What's happening?
We've had this problem for months with this group of bandits. We're getting drunk and murdering settlers. Last night, they went to a big place up near Reachwood.
They burnt the place down, killed the men, burning most of them alive, and raped the women. Women holding them up. One of them survived and walked in here this morning.
Anyway, we got a posse gathering up near Reachwood. Will you ride with us?
All right.
Thank you, John Marston. It's gonna be a bloody job.
Huh. I don't think I know any other kind, sir.
Hey, wait up!
Si no llega a decir lo de las mujeres, no... no se apunta.
All right, let's go. Together. Marston, I hear you caught up with Mr. West Dickens.
I did. For a man who claims to have found a remedy to all ailments, he was in pretty bad shape.
His tonic has helped a great many people. It's a medical breakthrough from the East, the result of years of research.
If only it could cure him of his diarrhea of the mouth.
I wouldn't be so dismissive of science if I was you. Times is changing fast.
He's no more a scientist than I am a priest. But people can spend their hard-earned money however they please.
He's certainly a character, that West Dickens.
I can't understand a goddamn word he said.
A more flannel-mouthed Funko artist I've never met.
Hey, Marshall, see those vultures?
We should check it out. Marston, Eli, go see what it is.
Me acuerdo que antiguamente, alquilando juegos... Te los pasabas en el fin de semana, sábado y domingo. Van a cesar.
Somebody was so busy killing people they went and dropped their gun.
La Winchester.
Such a thing.
Any number of people, especially now the word's out we're cleaning up the county.
Between Walton's boys and the rustlers, we've been spilling a lot of blood. Man gets more evil when he's running scared.
I can see more vultures up ahead.
We best take a look, boys.
Go!
Todos muertos también. ¿Por qué ha bajado el caballo, tío? Toc, toc. Estaba claro, ¿no?
Sweet mother of mercy.
Please, please don't shoot me. Some bandits came by and took us hostage. They're holed up in the farmhouse. Some of my family is being kept hostage inside.
All right, boys, we need to get into that house right now.
Vale. Dos menos. Tres. Hola. No, oh, tío. Uno está en el cuarto. Imagino.
Look like that's all of them. Let's see how the hostages are doing.
Some folk tried escaping to the south. But then some robbers started chasing him down like wild dogs. I thought you were supposed to protect us, Marshal. You folk ain't men. You ain't nothing. You're just a man on a government payroll taking money that the rest of us have to pay for with our lives.
Yeah.
What is wrong with this country?
Not up, men. The man that kills the boss of that bunch gets $50.
It ain't about the money, Marshal. These are people's lives. People's homes.
Let's go! Get on your horse, boy! Hurry, boys! Let's get after him!
Whoa, 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 whoa! Caballo, relaja!
Do you think they might be headed for Fort Mercer, Marshal?
What? Williamson's men?
Maybe! All this sure looks like their handiwork.
Makes sense if they cut this road.
Come on, Marshal! This might be our chance!
What should be for Williamson anyway, Marston?
Let's just say he's the currency in a complicated transaction.
What the hell you talking about?
Some people I have the displeasure of knowing want him dead.
Why does that involve you?
We used to run in a gang together. It was once like family.
If this is how you treat your family, I'd hate to see what you do to your enemies.
That was a long time ago. And bearing in mind, he's left me for dead the last two times I've seen him. I'm about 50.
Is that somebody on the cliff? You just walk away now, John.
I didn't kill you before, but I sure as shit will now.
Put yourself down here, Bill. You know you ain't man enough to stop me. You know I don't want to kill you, but I will.
You always did have a high opinion of yourself, John. Dutch always said you were an arrogant son of a bitch. I guess he was about right. Get him, boys! Everybody, take cover! In that shed!
This way!
You killed me! Keep together and stay in here!
Que nadie sabíamos aquí quién cojones era Dutch. Lo que nos perdimos.
Your help, John. Norman here is going to help us get to Bill. Ain't you, Norman?
Thank you, Mr. Dick. Mighty kind.
Fuck you.
Hog time. Let's get him to jail.
El chat ha volado.